Welcome to Sports Chat 503 out of Portland, Oregon. We've got the Duck Football Nation. Ed's having some problems right now. We've got Jeremiah Masoli, who's pled guilty down in Lane County. And we've got LaMichael James, who's pled guilty down in Lane County to some charges.
Yep.
And we've got some reaction from the coach, Chip Kelly, today.
Quick reaction.
Yeah. Yeah, which
within...
is...
within an hour.
Yeah, I think he probably, he may have been told, I don't know. Yeah, yeah, let's nip this in the bud, Lane County style.
Lane County.
But, yeah.
Beautiful county.
Yeah, great people. And, but, yeah, so what do you think of the verdicts and the Chip Kelly?
It's a tough day. I mean, you lose your starting quarterback for the year. I mean, I'm a big fan of Jeremiah Masoli. Saw him do great things in the Holiday Bowl.
Yeah.
Went to that with my family, had a great run. Went to the Rose Bowl as well, and saw him, you know, not do as well. My thing with Masoli is very simple. People wanted Masoli out of here halfway through last season. The season of the Rose Bowl, there were people all over clamoring, this isn't the right guy, he can't throw the ball, he can't do this, he can't do that.
Yeah, that's what I thought at the beginning of the year. I thought, this guy's not going to be our quarterback, is he?
Yeah. So for me, I mean, if you lose him at this point, it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm a huge believer in the backup quarterback we have. This kid, Darren Thomas, is for real. And I just believe that, you know, in college football, you don't have these guys for that long.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if they're there for a year, if they're there for 2 years,
yeah.
I mean, the Tim Tebow situation where you have him for 4 years is so rare these days.
Yeah.
And it seemed like an eternity. It seemed like two teams came and went with Tebow.
Yeah, you know? the league team The team where he was running the show.
It was like two different generations of Florida team while he was still there. He's like a grandpa at the end, you know? And it's just, you know, I mean, I feel bad for Chip that he has to go through this and has to have his star players. That's the main thing. You have LG last year. You've got LaMichael this year. And then Jeremiah. And the big thing for me also is the idea that Jeremiah is actually the bigger crime. Jeremiah is the bigger punishment with the law. And Jeremiah gets a one-game suspension. LaMichael gets a one-game suspension. While Jeremiah gets a year suspension or a full year or whatever for a lesser charge. The charge is against him is that he lied to the coach. That's the charge. That's what he's getting busted for. That's the season suspension.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I can understand the LG situation. LG went Ron Artest into the crowd. I mean, not full Ron Artest, but as close to Ron as you're going to get.
Yeah,
you know?
On a football field.
Yes, charged through an assistant coach, a national champion assistant coach, by the way. But bum rushed through an assistant coach and tried to, you know, basically rush the crowd. And that's, the punch was a two or maybe a three-game suspension, maybe a one-game suspension. That's all the NCAA wanted. But the rush in the crowd, that's what got LG into this sticky situation.
Yeah.
And bringing LG back, the reason why Chip did it is because he got with Dungy and he got with Edwards, Dr. James Edwards. And these guys said, LG's got to have something else to work for. He's got to have a carrot. He's got to have something to go for, something to strive for. Or else this whole situation doesn't work.
Yeah.
The punishment won't work. And so Chip agreed to that. He didn't know. He brought in somebody who did know.
Sure.
Who was privy to the information.
Good
idea. Yeah. And so he brings those people in. Those people end up helping the situation. And LG is a success story being from a very negative position where he was to begin with.
Yeah.
So
definitely.
I just look at it as a very simple, you know, Chip is trying to please a higher authority here. He's trying to please either Bilotti. He's trying to please the Duck audience. He's trying to please the fans. He's trying to please the media. He's trying to please all these people.
Mm-hmm.
So quickly, I thought the LG was a reaction. I think this is a reaction. I seriously think that the Darren Thomas era has begun, and we might not see Masoli again. We might see Masoli playing for Hawaii or playing for Nevada, playing for, I don't know, somebody else.
Yeah, because if he comes back after a year suspension, he'll either be... you know, struggling for playing time alongside, or
it'll be
just a straight backup.
Yeah, it'll be ugly.
You know, I'd like to have Masoli as a backup.
Oh.
I mean, you know, but I don't know if he would be good for that. And obviously...
team chemistry, all that.
Yeah, and I don't think we can really put off the development of other players Just from a solely to wait around and come back another year. Yeah. We gotta keep moving forward, but yeah, with the whole Chip Kelly dealing with the players. I think I remember seeing this about LeGarrette Blount situation where it's, you know, it's not really gonna be a win-win situation at all. You've got so many things that you've lost now. Yeah. You know, not just you know, the quarterback and the running back for a few games, quarterback for the year. But also, you know, you got your starting quarterback who's supposed to be your team leader glue. That lies to your face.
Glue.
And
you gotta trust him.
You know, yeah. I mean, that's almost
can't
worse.
Go to war with that guy.
That's almost worse than getting arrested and convicted of.
And if you're gonna steal,
crimes,
I mean,
you know?
The other thing is, I think from the university, you're stealing from university kids. Yeah. This is not going to the mini mart and yeah. trying to steal some candy. This is stealing from the university. This is not a good scene. And the other thing is man, you want to talk about this? I've met Jeremiah's family. I've seen them, how they roll. They are not happy.
Yeah.
right now. Yeah. They roll deep and they roll in a pack and they absolutely love this kid. And they're still supporting him. No joke. But I've met Jeremiah's mom, and I would not want to be Jeremiah right now. I would not want to be in his shoes right now because he has put his family in a very difficult position with this.
Yeah,
and that's tough because you know he had everything rolling for him. He had everything rolling. Yeah. He's not an NFL guy. I don't believe he's an NFL guy. I think if he's an NFL guy, he's like a fullback.
Yeah,
I mean he's more on that level, but he's got a great arm. Yeah. I think he's a CFL guy. I think he'd do great things in the CFL. I think he can play for 5-6 years and maybe long-term as a quarterback.
Yeah.
He could really do some things, but I don't see him as an NFL guy. And I feel so bad that I think that Chip Kelly had the perfect option quarterback.
Yeah.
A low to the ground, heavy runner who made that great split second decision.
Yeah.
Put the ball in the hands. He's strong-armed. Put the ball in the hands of the running back, yank that ball out, make that read if that end is coming in. If the end crashes, I'm gone off the edge. They can't catch him if the end crashes. If the end stays, you keep it up the middle with the running back and let him do his thing. Or you're following the running back as a, basically, running back and using the running back as a dive blocker. And I think that the future Darren Thomas can do that just as well as Masoli, but I know Masoli's cool customer under pressure. I know he can run the offense, and I have faith in Masoli.
Yeah. Yeah, the thing that gets me the most about this is the fact that, God, I really would have loved to see what the Ducks would have been like next year.
I agree.
With this lineup with Masoli and LaMichael in the backfield. And that almost angers me more than anything, it's damn it! Now I don't get to see how good they would have been, and it's selfish. You know, it's selfish. You know, I'm looking out for number one.
I'm trying to go to every game next year. I mean, I'm trying to go to every home game. I mean, I got a little boy, and I'm trying to get him into the experience of this whole thing. And
what a great opportunity they had, man.
And I think they still have it. I mean, I think they have a soft schedule coming into this year. I think they have teams where they want them. They don't have the home schedule like they had last year. Mm-hmm. They're going to play teams on the road. But, I believe in Chip Kelly. I just think that he's under so much scrutiny to make a hard decision and make these guys pay. And everybody wants a chunk of flesh on these kids. Mm-hmm. And I think that so much of that is an overreaction. I think you need to let these kids learn from it. You got to use it as a teachable moment. You have to learn from these mistakes.
Yeah. Yeah, it's tough, man. You got you got all this potential and I don't know, man.
Blowing it. It's
too
just
bad.
Gone. Mm-hmm. All right.
YouTube. Yep. Thank you very much for tuning in. Sports Chat 503.
Check out the other videos.
In Portland, Oregon.
Southeast, baby. We speak the truth on the 503, baby.
That's right. Be good.
All right. Adios.
Peace.